Hello students, as per the commitment, again I'm here with a lesson from your textbook, Oxford Progressive English by Rachel Radford for class 8. It's unit 6, food, and the topic is spaghetti bolognese. You children are familiar about all such type of food, spaghetti, pasta, macaroni or pizza. This is known as Italian food because it originates from Italy, from different cities of Italy. What is bolognese? Actually, it's an adjective taken from the noun Bologna, a city in Italy. For example, we people are known as Pakistani because we are belonging to Pakistan. Similarly, the thing which belongs to Bologna, the city of Italy, is known as bolognese. So spaghetti are basically originated from Bologna. That's why it's known as spaghetti bolognese. Objectives. By the end of the lesson, students will be able to paraphrase the lesson, means would be able to narrate the story in their own words, use the new words in their general conversation. There would be enhancement in their vocabulary, which they'll be using in their general conversation or in writing. Write answers of the given questions on page number 140 in your textbook. Unit 6, food, autobiography. We are told already the difference between biography and autobiography. Biography, which another person writes about the life events of the person, whereas autobiography, the person writes himself. Auto means self. So it's an autobiography. This text comes from the autobiography of Nigel Slayer. It's the name of the writer, Nigel Slayer, who grew up in the 1960s. He's a very well-known cookery writer. He's a famous writer who writes about food or the recipes. Here he records the first time he tasted spaghetti bolognese, which originates from Bologna in Italy and is now a very popular dish in Britain. In this lesson, he's sharing the experience when he tasted first time spaghetti. The Parmesan cheese traditionally sprinkled over the meat and tomato sauce is a very hard cheese with a very distinctive smell and comes from Parma in Italy. Okay, cheese which originates from the city of Italy, Parma, that's why it's called Parmesan cheese, which is being decorated over the spaghetti, which contains a very distinctive, or we can say, unique smell. Auntie Gertie is the elderly aunt of the boy's father. Auntie Gertie. The name of the woman is Gertie, but writer says auntie because she is her father's aunt, that's why. Okay, Auntie Gertie, who is the elderly aunt of the boy's father, who lived with the family. Let's continue with the lesson, spaghetti bolognese. Acha, for your information, I must tell you, even though you have seen in book, the lesson consists of 4 paragraphs, but for the convenience, in order to ensure that you have understood the lesson properly, in today's lesson, we'll be just continuing 2 paragraphs. Okay, let's begin with the paragraph 1. Neither Auntie Gertie nor Mom has eaten spaghetti before, and neither have I. Means boy is speaking, he's telling, that's why he's saying I. So none of these three members have ever eaten spaghetti. Dad is waiting for the water to boil on the stove. Stove means chula, jis par hum khana banate hain. So his father is waiting for the water to boil so that he may add spaghetti or the sticks of spaghetti in them. The sauce is already warm, having been poured from its tin a good half hour ago, and is sitting on the cool plate. Sauce, okay, the thick liquid made from different, like tomato sauce or garlic sauce and such type of sauce. Okay, so pour. Pour means when the flow of liquid from any container, or simply we can say the flow of liquid. So what he has done, he has taken out the sauce from that tin and he has just spread it on the plate to let it be cool. Giving just the occasional blip blob. If you remember, in our last lesson, in our previous lesson, we learned about figures of speech. There was onomatopoeia. What was there? The sound. So blip blob, we can, it's a sound which comes out when water or any other liquid boils. So that the bubbling sound that comes out, which is known as blip blob. When the water finally boils, my father shakes the strands of pasta out of the blue paper that looks like a great long firework. So what his father does, He's taking out the sticks of pasta. These are the hard sticks. He's taking them out from the packet, which looks like a firework. Patako ki tarah na phool ki tarah wo khule hue hain, sticks khule hue hain, that shines in long firework. And stands them in the bubbling water. And what he does, he's keeping, or he's just taking those pasta out of the packet and trying to put them into the water. Stands. Why is using the word stand? Because these are the sticks, so it could not be laid into the water. That's why he's trying to standing them. They splay out. Splay out means spread, phailna. When he's taking all the sticks of pasta into the water, they splay out. Wo phail jati. As the water comes back to the boy, he tries to push the spikes under the water. Again, he's trying to push. Unko jo na dhakel raha hai sticks ko, pasta ki sticks ko pani ke andar. They'll never all go in. He snaps. The father is speaking here. He's saying that they'll never all go in. So what he does, he snaps, trying to read the packet. Wo jaldi se mudte hain, snaps, he's moving. What he's trying to read the packet, which even when read with bifocals is in Italian. He's wearing glasses and trying to read the instructions which are written in Italian language. Some of the brittle sticks break in half and clatter over the hot plate. Brittle means easily broken, like koi cheez hoti hai na. So some of the brittle sticks, you know, wo sticks pasta ki wo toot jati hai, and they're just falling upon the plate and making the noise like clatter. So if such cheez kisi surface par girti hai to jo aawaz hoti clatter. Will it like it, daddy? I ask, half hoping he'll change his mind and mom will cook us all some chops. The boy is speaking, he's saying that, will I like it, daddy? And he's hoping that his dad will change his mind and mom will cook for him some chops. Chops, we can say, type of a meat, which is a stick to, like leg piece, we can say. Just try it, he says, a somewhat exasperated tone creeping into his voice. Just try it. So his father is speaking enthusiastically, excitingly, and he's just saying that, just try it. I think you should put some salt in it, chirps in mom. His mom excitingly speaks. She says, she advises to her husband that you should add some or put some salt in it. Auntie Gertie is looking down at her lap. Auntie Gertie is behaving like child. Her behavior is shown childish. So she is looking down at her lap. Do I have to have some? She says. I think she's going to cry. The boy is saying that when Auntie Gertie speaking, when she's saying that, do I have to have some? Kya main kha sakti hu ya mere khane ke liye milega, to boy is saying that she's going to cry. Paragraph 2. I think it must be done now, says my father 20 minutes later. The boy's father is saying, now it must be done. He drains the slithery. Slithery means smooth, which would be slide down. He drains the slithery lengths of spaghetti in a colander in the sink. Colander, metal, we can say, what type of tin metal, we can say, with small holes. Amuman hum ghar mein use karte hain sabziyan wagaira jo na wo pani mein jo na chhanne ke liye pani mein jo chhan liya jata hai, we are taking out the water, drain ho jata hai, a type of strainer. So what his father does, he's trying to he has kept all the spaghetti in the colander and crying, and he has kept it aside so that the water may be taken out from that. Some are escaping through the holes and curling up in the sink like nests of worms. Means a few, or some we can say, the strands of pasta are moving or being slipping out of the holes into the sink like worms. Quick, get the plates, they are getting away. The father is saying, bring your plate, they're getting away. We all sit there staring at our piles of pasta on our plates. They are sitting and they are having now pasta on their plates and they're looking at each other. Oh, I don't think I can, solve Auntie Gertie, who then picks up a long sticky string with her fingers. What she does, Auntie Gertie, she takes up one strand, a long strand of pasta, and she, by looking at that strand, she's just like sobbing. Matlab, she's behaving like child. Wo ro rahi hai, and she's saying that she can't. रूमिंग खा सकती। नो वेट फॉर द साग गाटी मदर्स आईज एंड देन कम ऑन डैडी हरी अप द मदर शी इज जस्ट आस्किंग गाटी दैट वेट फॉर द सॉस लेट द सॉस बी ब्रॉट सो दैट वी मे हैव अ ड्रेसिंग ऑफ सॉस ओवर द स्पैगेटी Dad spoons the sauce, a slurry of reddish-brown mince that smells foreign over the knots and twills of pasta. So what Dad does, he's just taking a spoon of sauce. What type of sauce? It's a slurry of reddish-brown mince. It's been a thick liquid bana hua, a mince ka, chopped borscht ka, that smells foreign, unique, a different smell de raha hai, over the knots and twills of pasta. And he's just dressing that sauce over the knots and twills. We can say it's jutta jo bana hua, as you can see in the picture. Unke upar wo sauce dal rahe. Suddenly, it all seems so grown up, so sophisticated. And suddenly, it seems that the situation is now is they like, or we can say they are just behaving like grown up. Okay, it was paragraph 1 and 2. We'll be continuing paragraph 3 and 4. Till then, you're supposed to revise or read again and again so that your concept should be clear. And after reading, you are supposed to attempt questions, as you can see on your screen, on 140 page, question 1, 2, 3, and 4, you're supposed to attempt in order to ensure that you have understood the lesson clearly. And we'll be continuing paragraph 3 and 4 in our next class. Till then, take care. And for your convenience, vocabulary is also being given so that you may have help. Okay, see you in next class. Till then, take care. Allah Hafiz.